up, people? Hey, what's going on? It's BrickDog24, Josh Brickus for Draft Best Ball Championship, heading into the bye weeks. We finished out week three late last night, and we are moving on into week four. Bye weeks for the Jets and the Niners, and that's it for this week. So that'll start coming into play if people drafted and have injuries and stuff like that. Shake up the standings a little bit from here going forward. So I did not have a great week. I definitely dropped my first places down a notch from like 18 to like 11, I think. I didn't really have a lot of the guys that performed well this week, such as Mike Evans and Alvin Kamara. I'm not big on those two guys percentage ownership-wise. So, therefore, some guys leapfrog me that have some of those. So, we'll take a look at a few of my teams and how they're doing and where they're at. I actually started to name some of these because I just want to know who I have that's out for the year. I didn't get through all of them. I just started naming some of them. So, that way, if I think I have a chance and then I have bye weeks, I realize some of these guys are going to hurt me like luck. McKinnon and Foreman on one team, stuff like that. So, obviously I spelled McKinnon wrong there as I was typing on my phone. So we'll take a look at these. Also, they did put out a pretty interesting tournament for $33. It starts week five. So not this week, but next week, and it goes to week 12. 50,000 to first place. I did a few of them already. It's pretty interesting to see how people are drafting now. You know, that the injuries and certain players are doing better and worse and stuff. It shakes up the ADP. Big time difference from the beginning of the season. So, interesting to see. We'll take a look at those. And my week three small drafts. I was big on Josh Jacobs, if you remember from last week. I showed you him, but my biggest ownership was Keenan Allen. So, that was a huge call, but Jacobs I definitely missed on. Week three was my worst of the 3 weeks so far as the single week drafts. However, I did nail a four-man $55 that started week one, and 10K going to first place. I need to win two more times. So, I think that is, it's one of the, yeah, it's the five wide. So, yeah, this is a nice one here. Contest details, four-man draft, and we are actually in, they still didn't fix this. We are actually into, it's much easier to pick up stuff on my phone than I'm not as familiar on here, so I don't know where the payouts are at. They should be right there, but they're not. So anyway, this is round three. I have to win. I'm guaranteed like $300 for 55 right now. And I win the four-man two more times. This is who I'm up against, if you guys know any of these guys. And then next week will be for the 10K. Just have to win this week, and then I'll be playing for a nice chunk of change next week. So I have to dig in and see who I like for the current week. Obviously, Mahomes, Watson, and Jackson for quarterbacks. I also am big on Russell Wilson against Arizona this week. I don't think you can go wrong with the way Matt Ryan's been playing. Some of these other guys are a gamble. Rivers does have a nice matchup. But I don't think in a four-man you need to dig that deep. In a six-man, maybe. But a four-man, I think you're looking at these three plus like Wilson or, you know, somewhere in this range. Running backs, McCaffrey's going one every time. Eckler's still up there because Gordon isn't playing. Eckler has a great matchup. I like Chubb and Cook even with the tough matchups this week. I like Chubb and Cook, Kerryon Johnson. Derrick Henry's getting the ball a lot more than some of these other guys, so I like that. I think Jacobs will have a bounce back, but I'm going to stay away from it. Carson's in trouble. I'm not going to touch Gallman. Let's see. Receivers, Keenan Allen, I'm huge on again. I mean, he's just a beast, and he has a great matchup. Julio. Evans, you know, I mean, coming off a monster week, and he's still a top-tier receiver, so I just always seem to fade Evans for whatever reason. Winston's very up and down. Love Hopkins, and I love Cooper Kupp, and Tyler Lockett has a great matchup as well. So those are the guys I'm looking to target. And this is a four-man draft, so you don't really have to go too deep. Although, if I need to, I have some guys down here I like Christian Kirk. Seattle on defense let up a bunch of yards week one, and they've been kind of okay since then. But I like the amount of balls that Kirk's getting thrown his way, and Kyler's just getting more comfortable each week. So there's some guys down in here. Sterling Shepard, I even like. He's getting a lot of targets now, and I think Daniel Jones is going to be okay. I mean, I know it's only 1 week, but first round talent, and looked good in the preseason, and looked good in his first game when he should have been pretty nervous. So I think he'll be settled in a little bit, and we'll see what happens with him going forward. I'm not going to take any shares of him right now, quarterback, but as far as Shepard and Evan Ingram, I think they probably have the same or better value than they did with Eli. So that's kind of where I'm at for the four mans, and I'm excited for that one. I did actually win three of my other ones, two hype trains and a first and 10. So this is a four man and 2 6-mans going on, and then some other stuff here. Week four drafts, I already maxed out all of mine, I think. The hype train starting short and first and 10. So, again, these are all the guys I just told you I liked. So, that's one of my favorite lineups there. And I think people are going to be a little weary about Chubb and maybe even Cook with these matchups, but I'm not so worried. I mean, Kansas City put up a buck 60 or whatever they did in rushing with multiple running backs on Baltimore. So, I think Chubb is more talented than that group, and he should be fine. I normally don't stack, but it was kind of hard to pass Lockett up with the very last pick when I already had Wilson. I mean, he had a big week, but he has an even better matchup this week, and I think they'll be fine there in Arizona. So that's that. Season longs again. We'll take a look at a few. Here's one that's in first, 471 points. Week three. When you have Mahomes and he's playing the way he's playing, I mean, it's there's my Kamara. See, I have Kamara. This lineup looks really good. Mahomes, Kamara, and Cook. Kamara really only had that one bad week, so I guess he's gonna be all right even with Bridgewater in there. So, and Cook's just a beast. DJ Moore only had two targets, but he made the most of the one with Kyle Allen in there. So. Kyle Allen probably playing again this week, and I don't know how long after that, but probably a little bit less on DJ Moore right now until we see how that pans out. And then when Cam comes back, I think DJ Moore's value goes back up. This is the team that I have Mahomes with DeMarcus as well, so he scored again. That helps. Evan Ingram is just a monster and could be just even better with Daniel Jones, so we'll see. Nice running backs I have here. Kamara, Cook, and Fournette, who, although he's getting the touches, hasn't done a whole lot. He had one long run that kind of made up for that, so we'll see what happens with him going forward. But hopefully he plays a little better. Jamal Williams, I guess he got banged up. What's it say here? Limited participant Monday. Huh. They're talking about giving him more carries and stuff, and that's good for me. I have a good amount of ownership of him, and 12 carries is not too bad for what's supposed to be a backup running back. So not terrible there. A lot of targets for Marquise, but Lamar was just a little off this week, and I'm not sure how that's going to shake out. But, I'm still pretty high on him, so we'll see what happens with him there. But I do like this team because there's not a lot of dead spots. Both of these guys here should be back when it counts. I hope so. It'll be nice to have the Tyreek Mahomes connection, and Njoku should be back around Thanksgiving. Funchess, I don't know if he's out for the year or just most of the year. The IR thing confuses me now because they only have to be out for 6 weeks. So some of the guys are out for the year, some aren't. Moncrief, complete dud. And Elijah McGuire, I think, is on the Browns now, but he's on the practice squad. So nothing doing there for now on Elijah. But Chase Edmonds, backup candidate there. And Jalen Richard, not much action in Oakland. But the starting core here is pretty solid. I'm going to have to get lucky on some bye week stuff and stuff like that with this bench, but I really like that squad as far as the main core there, and we have a nice little lead there. So that's a first place team. Let's look at one of the ones that's towards the bottom. Goff just has not really done a lot yet. I mean, 38 passes this week, but he didn't even throw for 300 yards and only two touchdowns. He had three turnovers. So not great. We have Kamara and Mac, which is not bad. We have the combo with Cooks. So, and Chubb's in there, Ingram. Oh, that's really bad. Alshon's in there with a zero. Oh, we must have no bench. Let's see what's going on here. Jeez, oh man. We must be dead here. Okay, Kiki, no good. Tyreek's hurt. Marquise Lee hasn't done anything. Demaryius hasn't played. So, yeah, that's really bad. If Alshon's out, that team is in trouble. Well, that's probably why they're in 11th. You can't take zeros. You definitely cannot take zeros. Ben's out for the year. This team's and Foles is hurt, too. So, we got a banged-up squad up in there. So, no, that's why it's in 11th. Some of these guys are in 2nd or 3rd. Like, this is basically a first-place team here. I mean, look at that. It's not even a yard. So, let's take a look at this team here. When I count my first place, I just go through and look at one. So this is pretty much a first place team, at least a tie with that guy. He's got me by a couple yards there. Some guys that haven't really done too much. I mean, David Johnson, Cooks, you know, have room to have higher ceilings. Darren Waller had a big week. I got two nice tight ends in this one. Garoppolo good last week and not so good this week. Henry's good. I got lots of San Fran combos there. So Garoppolo does stuff, then that should be good. No major injuries here. I don't know why I have Haskins. I bet you that might be the only one or two teams I have him on. But with Keenum's 5 turnovers this week, that could end up working out. And this is a complete dud. And I bet you if I check my ownership on both of these two guys, this might be the only lineup I have them in. So that's interesting considering this is basically a first, second place team here. That I have both of them. I have 4 quarterbacks. That's really unlike how I drafted at all. Wentz and Garoppolo are fine. Garoppolo on a bye this week, so we got Wentz, and that's it. So, interesting that I have these two guys. But nonetheless, I do. Like I said, not a lot of first place ones after this week. Some seconds. There's a 4-11 behind Stevie by 27. Melvin Gordon, hopefully he comes back soon. We shall see. Freeman hasn't done much. Kiki's useless right now. Won't need Hunt till later. Darnold should be back after the bye. Butler's out. Darwin's killing me. I was really hoping they got a chance this week, and he didn't because Darrell Williams kind of took over. So, yeah. Deontay had a nice game, so we'll see what happens with him. 12th place team, nice, 299 points. Darrell Henderson, I don't own him much, which is good, but I do on this one. AJ Green should be coming back one of these days. Foreman, zero. Cousins, terrible. Kumaro, zero. And Thomas hasn't really played much. So, yeah, you can see why that team's in 12th. It's fun to look at these sometimes, but let's see. Grab one other good one, and then I'll check out the $33. See what's going on there. There's a second place mini behind 35 points. Got Saquon. That hurts. And Andrew Luck. That's nice. Saquon and Andrew Luck and Funchess and Gallup. And Darwin. And, yep, that team's a hurting for our second place team. Who else quarterback-wise we had there? Oh, Dak. Okay. It is interesting to see some of this stuff. There's a first place. Best ball, 405 points. 17-point lead. I see a pattern here. People don't like to take quarterbacks early, but the one pattern we've seen on all my first place teams, I think I have Mahomes. So, pretty interesting. Sanders is in trouble with his job there, losing some fumbles. So, says one. I thought he lost two. Maybe the other one he got back. Or they got back. Combo, Mahomes and Hardman. Michael Thomas. Freeman only can get better, I think. Tyrell is still okay. Olsen, as long as he's healthy, I mean, that looks good. And that is with the backup quarterback, which I'm not surprised that they try to rely on a tight end. Some backups here on the bench. Carson, I'm scared about his job with the fumbles. But I do have Penny in this one, so that's good. Breeze will be back down the road. We have him. We have Tyreek coming back down the road. Deshaun's out another week. And Dexter's been inactive for Jamal. But if Jamal's hurt, then Dexter goes in, I guess. So got them both here in this one. But I only have Breeze and Mahomes. Breeze will be back before Mahomes' bye week, so that's pretty good. Not a bad squad there. Not great, not terrible. Here's another first place. 444 on this one, mini, in the mini best ball. All right, gang. I was kind of looking at it as well, so some guys coming back here. And Saquon's out, so that's no good. All right, so in the lobby, they have a $33 Best Ball Championship, 250K guaranteed, and 50K to first place. 18 rounds, same lineup as the preseason championships. It just starts week 5 and goes to week 12. Everything else is the same. You can see the payouts here. You have to win your 12-man through week 12, which is only a 7-week season. So, obviously, the Niners and Jets get a little boost. And then you get top 3 for week 13, 14, 15, and some nice money here in the finals for only $33. So I fired a few of these so far. Not sure how many I'm going to do. You can cap at 150, but I don't know if I will do a whole lot. It's interesting, and I think there is going to be an overlay. They don't even have 10% filled, so they got more than 90% still to fill. And they have about a week and a half. Starts next Thursday, I believe. So about 9 days for them to get moving on that one. So there should be an overlay, which would entice me, and I'm sure others, to fire some more. So if that's the case, I'll probably get in there. But it is kind of interesting. I don't have any money in my account right now in order to show you guys. Oh, I could show you. Upcoming. Oh, here we go. So here is two lineups. I did two lineups. One I don't really like. The second one I kind of like. So let's just take a look. But you'll see how different it is here. Let's see. Tournament. How do I see? It doesn't show me where I drafted them at, huh? All right. So we got Dak and Cooper. We got Lev and Breida. Again, like I said, the Jets and Niners with their bye week before this thing starts is pretty beneficial. So I took Lev in the first round for that reason. And then I took Breida and Tevin Coleman. I grabbed Hunter Henry. I think it was like 11th round or something. So, same with Breeze. I grabbed some of these guys late because I do have a decent amount of good starters in here to kind of hold me off until maybe these guys get in. I did go with a Daniel Jones here, but I also have Breeze, so we'll see what happens there. I grabbed a combo with Jones. Some tight end that I would have never drafted. Preseason is now in there with Hunter Henry, and I have Ebron. So not the greatest at tight ends. It's weird doing these things. It doesn't feel as good. It doesn't look as good on paper. I like my receivers, obviously. Kirk's been getting a ton of targets. Tyrell, I mean, I got four nice receivers there, in my opinion. But this isn't as sexy looking as it would be preseason. But the way that it's going right now, I mean, Dak's a top, three quarterback. Cooper had a big game. Lev's playing pretty well, getting a lot of catches. So, and Cooper's just killing it. So, Royce Freeman, I still believe he's going to overtake Lindsey. I know Lindsey had a good game and a couple touchdowns, but I do think that that's still going to happen. So I did roll with him there. I was hoping Jamal's going to be splitting carries, so that's why I took him. I like Deontay's upside. I have Devin Smith in the 18th round just because I have, or maybe the 17th round, Slayton in the 18th, but one or the other. And then I have Dak as the combo with Cooper as well as Devin Smith, at least for a while Gallup's out. I'm not a big fan of Cobb. I think Devin Smith has more potential for decent. So, all right. That's that. Here's the other lineup. This is my first one I did. I don't love it, but again, I took a lot of Niners and Jets. I just feel like there's nicer value there because they aren't going to have a bye week. So the only reason you're taking, I don't know, you know what I mean. You basically have less chances of getting a zero. You don't have to worry about bye weeks and having the same bye weeks or anything. And it's one more game that they're going to get in there. So the only way they can really screw you over is an injury. So it's nice to have that behind you, and it's the only two teams that are going to have that. So I'll be all over some Niners and Jets for sure. So I got Robbie, Dak again with Cooper again. So I've done two, and I have the same combo in both. This one I have Derek Carr and Tyrell Williams as well. Don't think I got any. I got Breida and Garoppolo, but no Niner receivers. Devin Smith again. Jordan Howard, I think, with Miles Sanders' fumbles, might start to get a few more carries. Not that he's that great, but if he's getting more touches and that offense starts to do a little better, maybe he will. So Hooper's been good. Hopkins, I love. Obviously, he's the number one. He's just didn't have a great week or two, but 2 weeks in a row, he hasn't been great, but he'll be fine. I'm not worried about him. Carry on. He doesn't really have any competition, and he's going to get the ball, so not terrible there either. But Hunt, I don't know. Hopefully later. I mean, it's weird. I don't really love these lineups, but it is what it is right now, and you'll see if you do any of these, you know, the ADP and how things are going. All right, it's been 20 minutes. Thanks for watching, guys. Please make sure you hit the subscribe button. Also, if you could hit the thumbs up button on any of these videos that you like, I would certainly appreciate it. And we're trying to grow this channel into a, not just the breaks, but also fantasy talk and just kind of random funny videos that I have. And I'm just trying to build a little bit of an audience. So if there's anything you want to hear, see with draft or anything else, let me know. But make sure you subscribe to the channel and hit the like, the thumbs up buttons on any of the videos that you like. Thank you. Have a good one.